So let's talk about a highly anticipated game that is being released in November of this year. It has been in development hell for about 10 years now. And it is a game that I personally have been really looking forward to ever since I first saw the E3 cinematic experience back in, I think, 2017. The game that I am, of course, talking about is Skull and Bones, which is being developed by Ubisoft. For the reason that this game has garnered so much hype and so much attention, and for myself personally, is because back in 2013, Assassin's Creed Black Flag was released and literally introduced us to the pirate game we didn't know that we needed or wanted. And for those of you that never played Black Flag or didn't have the opportunity to play Black Flag, it took everything great that was with Assassin's Creed, the sword fighting, the gunplay, the gameplay, and then incorporated an entire pirate theme with that. So not only were you running around on land, sword fighting, pistol throwing, you know, killing people and pillaging and things like that, but then you got on a ship, and on your ship you would sail across the seas, encounter other ships, have epically awesome ship battles at that time, and still to this day would be extremely fun to play. But then you had the opportunity to jump on that boat by utilizing ropes or just jumping into the water and swimming up against the boat if you disabled it. And then you would board the boat, destroy and kill everybody on the boat if you wanted to, or you could even take some as prisoners once they finally gave up. It was the ultimate pirate experience. So of course, when Skull and Bones was announced and I saw it and I was like, oh my God, Ubisoft is making this. Like, of course, myself and anybody else who plays Black Flag is going to be extremely hyped and like, yes, yes, like a freaking pirate MMO with Assassin's Creed. Take my money, Ubisoft. I will gladly give it to you in order to play a more complete pirate adventure just like that. But now that we've had a bunch of gameplay releases, we had an entire like gameplay showcase, which I reacted to, and I'll link that up above and down below in the comments. You can check that out if you want to. I am now saying, Ubisoft, you will not be taking any of my money because you're releasing a game that is a quarter of a game that was released in 2013. And I would suggest that anybody else who is now watching this video, do not buy this game. Oh, did I mention that this game is $60 for the base cost? And if you're on a new console, you have to pay $70 for this game. Now, they haven't mentioned like a battle pass or season pass as of yet, but I'm anticipating that they're going to include one of those, if, considering that this is a live service game. So not only are you going to be paying the base price for the game, I'm assuming you're going to have to end up paying for like a season or battle pass later on once they realize that the cosmetics probably aren't pulling as much money as they want. Okay, I'm probably being a little overdramatic, right? So let's see what Skull and Bones does offer. Does it have a story? What's the story like?
Pivotal characters or kingpins in the game that you'll meet in your journey through the game, and they will have bits of story and background that you will be able to do with jobs or the contracts with them. But it is definitely not a storyline driven game. You don't finish Skull and Bones and have a credits and a cutscene at the end. So it's something we want to perpetuate as a live game for years and years to come.
Okay, so there's no real story, but there are like characters and like NPCs that you can interact with, and that kind of like give like the backstory of like, I guess, like the area that we're playing in and the world and things like that, right? I mean, that's okay. I understand from like the perspective that they, you know, they want it to be an online experience. So you're kind of like making your own story as you go. But at that point, you're really relying on like a really large player base in order to drive the story forward. And as a live service, what are they going to implement like in the future to keep things intriguing? Okay. So if there is no campaign, then what exactly are we doing?
So it's about bringing some dangerous contraband to different places around the world, or going after and taking out named pirates that are causing trouble for one of the kingpins, or plundering one of the settlements to get a certain item.
Okay, so there's transportation missions, maybe like escort missions, there's the plundering, and then there's killing of famous pirates. So at least you have a solid, what, four things to do there, because everybody loves escort missions. And if I recall, there's no actual like hand-to-hand combat. Everything is all ship battle based, and that's supposed to keep people engaged for an ongoing live service game without getting boring. Okay, so we've established that there's no story, but there are obviously like a bunch of quests and things that you can do in order to gain like experience and raise your reputation. So what is the progression system like then?
Your name is a big deal. So how can we work in this risk reward, the progression into something that you basically risk as they did back in this time when you're taking on activities? So if you sink a big ship or a named ship, people hear about it and your infamy grows. And that gives you access to different pirates wanting to work with you and do deals with you. And that's exactly the same flow that our progression follows. If you play Skull and Bones, you play regularly and you invest the time, you will reach Kingpin. But Kingpin is where a new type of experience starts, and that can end up being a little bit more competitive.
Okay, so that's pretty vague, but obviously you start off, you know, as being just a poor little guy, and then you have to work your way up through the ranks in order to become, you know, a pirate kingpin. And that apparently unlocks newer stuff that they can't or won't discuss. I'm assuming that means that then you join like a local leader or a worldwide leaderboard, and then, you know, the more reputation and things that you earn, it pushes you up the ranks. That's probably the competitive nature of that. But all that I'm hearing from this is a very grindy game of doing the same exact missions over and over again in order to raise your reputation. That doesn't sound really satisfying, and it sounds really limited and boring with not a whole lot of variety. Okay, so before we jump into like the whole ship stuff, what is the gameplay on land like? How immersive is it?
So in the dens, this is where you'll have your warehouse, where you will most likely be socializing with other pirates, where you can craft all of your different weapons and new ships and those kind of things, where you can refine materials. Outposts, which are scattered all the way throughout the world, these rotate. So it could be one of the factions is at that outpost at this time, and they're offering a certain set of contracts just for the time that they're actually there in that outpost. Places where you buy the new blueprints or designs as you progress through infamy will be in these outposts. You'll also be able to find some resources. You'll be able to find treasure maps, which are pretty cool in the game. You'll find bits of lore that lead to the story. Why is everybody here? What happened? There's a deeper underlying story that it's not a linear narrative, but it's something you can investigate and learn about.
Okay, so outposts and dens, and they're not everywhere. They're like scattered throughout. And this is where you do your crafting, you take contracts, you do refining and blueprints. So it's like a pause screen. It's like a pause screen. So there's no, if I see another pirate, I have the option to just, you know, if I want to, I can just kill him. There's nothing like that. It's just a place where it's like a social hub. It's a social hub with a couple of treasure chests hidden around.
Hello, darkness, my
all right.
Friend.
Okay. I'm also assuming this means that like you can't just navigate to an island and like explore. So like you're really limited to just exploring in the ocean or at a hub or outpost, and like that's it. Where's the pirate adventure? Okay, so the land sounds extremely boring. Since I'm going to be spending 99% of the time on a boat, what's the deal with the boats then? What are the features with the boats? What's the combat? What's the customization?
To build a unique ship that inspires fear onto your enemies, there are three steps. Step one, pick your weapons and ammo. This will make or break your battles. From piercing ammo that ignores armor and causes flooding, to tearing ammo that rips your enemy's sails apart, slowing them down for an easy kill, my favorite is crushing as it deals a devastating blow to most armor. Step two, choose your armor. With our game's weapon counter system, there will be an armor that can counter each damage type. That's how we keep tension high at sea. Lastly, it's the look of your ship. Put on your scariest war paint and head out with a ship that is instantly recognizable. Making this quick adjustment will transform you from sneaky smuggler to hard-hitting hunters or Swift traders.
Okay, cool. So there's like a lot of customization when it comes to like the weapons and the overall appearance. You can set, you know, change the sails, the front ornaments, the cannons, the armor. This is obviously where they're going to implement their cash shop and where you can buy the customizations. And I guess this is where they are going to basically fund the ongoing live service for this game. It still feels really underwhelming. Like, Black Flag had ship customization. You were able to change your cannons. You were able to change your armor. And then different ships. So, obviously, they're going to be going down the whole, like, pimp your ship route. Which is really cool. But what about the naval combat? What does the combat look like?
I think it's very intuitive. It's very easy to pick up with sailing your different ships that we have in the game. Combat is something that we also wanted to make sure that is very intuitive, something that's, you know, like if you were playing a shooter. As you do damage, your crew gets kind of whipped into this fervor, and at some point you'll be able to execute what we call a crew-to-crew attack. If you time it right to where your enemy ship is lower health, they will execute a boarding maneuver, and that hooks them in, they strap in, and that's the only way that you get all the loot in the cargo.
So I will say that when I observed their naval combat with the gameplay showcase they had, it does seem to be very, very smooth. The attacks, like lining up the attacks, aiming, navigating through the actual ocean, bracing against impact, all seems very fluid, very smooth. So when your cannons or your mortars, when you're doing like big attacks and you're ramming other ships, everything seemed to carry the weight and like the ships would react in a very nice way. Primarily, like at least they have nailed the ship combat when it comes to this game. It might be lacking in all other areas, but the ship combat looks very, very, very good. Oh, by the way, when he says about, you know, being able to hook onto a ship and plunder it, that last cutscene, that is the only cutscene that I saw when they had their showcase and they boarded like five or six ships. It just played the same animation over and over again. Okay, so we have reached the end of this video, as I think my time's kind of dragging on a little bit here, but I'm gonna have my final closing thoughts and comparisons, and then after that, I'm actually gonna have two clips play with Skull and Bones beside Assassin's Creed Black Flag, just so you can really see the comparison here. Skull and Bones graphically looks amazing. It's a beautiful looking game. The ocean, it looks like you could just literally like sail around the game itself and just feel really content, especially with like sea shanties. The boat combat looks great. It looks very smooth, very fluid, very satisfying combat. But that's about it. I don't know how anybody could remain entertained with this game after probably a good 8 to 10 hours of solid gameplay. I think at that point, it's just going to be extremely repetitive, doing the exact same missions over and over and over. A game that's been in development for this long should not be released with no content. I don't know how that even happened. Like, this game literally has so many less features than a game that they already released in 2013. So that's pretty much my closing thoughts on it. I'm not buying this game until the price is dramatically gone. I think this is a game that's not gonna actually be any fun to really play after those first like 8 to 10 hours, until the game is much further down its development path and like a bunch more content has been released. I would suggest you do the exact same, because it is absolutely ridiculous that they are charging full price for a game that has only a couple features in it. So with that being said, let's go over the comparisons from Black Flag, which was released in 2013, and Skull and Bones, which is going to be released in November of 2022. Okay, so let's start off with Skull and Bones features. It has beautiful graphics and ocean exploration, boat combat and boat customization, crafting. It has a user/community driven story. Now let's talk about the features Black Flag had. For its time, it had beautiful graphics and ocean exploration. Second, it had boat combat and customization. Third, it had crafting. Fourth, it was Assassin's Creed, so it had an extremely deep story. Fifth, there was island and town exploration all over the place. If there was an island out there and you saw it, you could go to it and pretty much walk around it. Next, it has hand-to-hand combat, regardless of where you are, on your ship or on land. It also had the ability to actually board your enemy ships and to take their loot. Another feature is it actually had ocean diving, meaning you could actually jump off and dive down into the ocean to hunt for treasure. I don't think I really need to say anything else. You know my opinion and you know my viewpoint, and you can see it on the screen as well. That's going to be pretty much it for this video. Be sure to check out the last clip here. Like I said, I'm going to show you what Black Flag looks like compared to Skull and Bones. And if you like this video, please do me a favor and hit the thumbs up to help with the algorithm. And if you like more of this content, please subscribe to my channel. Check it out all down below. I have a lot more content. Thank you guys. Have a good one. Right. Well, that makes sense.
You guys are hanging around the outside.
What are you doing?
Well, take some orders, buddy.
I'm sending some.
Okay.
Look at.
I want to talk him. Sea swabby. Right.
Oh. Yes. Aggravated.
This one is not going to last very long.
All right, well, I was going to say that was like a badass ship, but it just like deleted. Okay. So now they're going to board, right?
Are you still going at it over there? You should repair.
Wait, what?
Okay, I'm in the middle of a boarding.
Oh, so is that over or did that like just switch off? Is that all it does?
It's dangerous if you do it at the wrong time, right?
Yes.
But I think, I'm okay.
Whoop, that was actually you. Good thing I can't do damage. If you're in the red circles, you can brace
yeah.
Oh, look at the damage. Look at the damage. Okay, that's pretty nice looking.
Out here. Try to burn him a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Come on, let's board her. Let's board her.
We definitely got to stay in close so you can't kind of, you know, sail away.
Yo, heave-ho! Heave!
Sideways. Arrgh.
consign their bones to Davy Jones.